And doctor's note news. Submitted by Alpha Kenny Body.
That's so fucking old. That's so old.
I want to be a part of a frat that's called Alpha Kenny Body.
That's tight.
What about Sofa King?
Yeah.
We. Tart.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Donald Trump's personal doctor has admitted that he did not write the letter attesting to Trump's extraordinary health.
I heard about this. This dude looks weird as fuck, by the way. His doctor looks like a fucking hippie. It's super bizarre.
What does he look like?
Can we rewind a little bit?
Does he have a white coat or like a red coat?
Well, the photo I have of him.
Can we just rewind? And what's going on with this note? How did this note come about? What's this note all about?
Yeah, what's the backstory?
So, back in December 2015, Donald Trump's personal physician released this letter saying that his patient's health was perfect and that he would be like the best, like the most healthiest president to ever.
The best, most healthiest.
Yeah, best, most
you
healthiest.
You can already tell just visually through his Sunny D looking skin. this fool is not healthy at all.
No.
That's crazy.
So this is what the letter said. Oh, would you like to read?
Yes.
Anybody with a little bit of belly, I don't think they're at the most healthiest. Oh. Life.
But this cat's 70 years old.
Oh, Donald Trump's 70?
Yeah.
Really? Oh. Oh,
he's 70.
But he's ashy and tan at the same time.
Well,
it's so weird.
But he's also, I mean, dude, remember when he was doing all those rallies? He's doing like 7 rallies a day or whatever the fuck? Like, I don't even think I could do one of those without bitching the whole time.
Those are hard.
Yeah, I'd be bitching, dude.
So just pay attention to the way this was written, because this is so obvious the doctor didn't write this.
Okay. To whom my concern? I have a personal I have been the personal physician of Mr. Donald J. Trump since 1980. His previous physician was my father, Dr. Jacob Bordenstein. Over the past 39 years, I am pleased to report that Mr. Trump has had no significant medical problems. Mr. Trump has had a recent complete medical examination that showed only positive results. Actually, his blood pressure, 110 over 65, and laboratory test results were astonishingly excellent. Over the past 12 months, he has lost at least 15 pounds. Mr. Trump takes 81 milligrams of aspirin daily and low dose of statin. His PSA test score is 0.15. Parentheses, very low. This is the way that Trump
tweets.
Yeah, this is literally how he tweets.
His physical strength and stamina are extraordinary. Mr. Trump has suffered no form of cancer, has never had a hip, knee, or shoulder replacement, or any other orthopedic surgery.
He wrote his own doctor's note.
This is great. His only surgery was an appendectomy at age 10. His cardiovascular status is excellent. He has no history of ever using alcohol or tobacco products. If elected, Mr. Trump, I can state unequivocally, will be the healthiest individual ever elected to the presidency, that I can tell you. And anyone saying otherwise, it's sad.
Wait, he didn't drink?
He never uses alcohol?
Product? No, he does not drink, he doesn't smoke.
Apparently he doesn't.
He doesn't do drugs, that's his whole thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh shit, that's crazy.
That's what he told his kids too, he doesn't, no drinking, smoking alcohol. Or no drugs, smoking alcohol.
I always forget that he's 70, or about to be 70.
Yeah, because he looks like he's not 70, that's what I'm saying.
He looks like shit, though.
Well, but
he doesn't look like old shit. He just looks like shit, but like general, a younger, shitty version of what. Yeah.
He looks his age, though. Like, he looks old.
But you know, like yeah.
He
like,
doesn't
like,
look 70.
He's gonna be 72 soon.
Really? He looks pretty 70 to me.
Maybe I'm comparing him with Richard Branson, who just looks very, like vibrant and like he just looks
healthy. Looks old as fuck.
Richard
too.
Branson's hair maybe looks vibrant, but the rest of him
he looks pretty old.
He looks like he's
he
full
looks capable
of energy.
Yeah.
Well, he's fit. Richard
he
Branson?
Is, he is.
Yeah.
But he still looks old as fuck.
Oh yeah, but he's like a fit old.
Yeah.
Cuz like my mom is 66 or 67 now. So I'm like, "Yo, Trump looks way older than my mom."
Oh, I see.
You know who's old but is like young and vibrant? That fucking dude that's tatted all over? That rich guy, the billionaire that's always dancing with his model wife?
What? He's tatted everywhere?
Giovanni or whatever. But, fuck,
his name is Giovanni Giugani. His name is a parody name in a parody
he's
movie?
He's all fucking tattooed up. He's always on a yacht and shit and fucking dancing. He's like always
so
fucking
people.
Dancing.
He's always dancing.
Yeah, he's always dancing.
Sounds like Rick Ross so far.
No, but then like he
but
yeah.
Not fat.
I think he's a fucking fashion guy or something, but
and he's tattered all
what
up.
What about him again?
Yeah, he's tattooed. He looks like he's like late 60s, mid 60s. I don't know. He looks like a grandpa, but he's fucking like chiseled and he's like, is it like
Danny
a cool
Trejo?
Oh wait, what's your point?
I'm just saying Trejo he's the guy that looks vibrant and healthy, but he's old.
Oh, yeah. I see.
Yeah, so this doctor here, he's saying that Trump now he's telling CNN that Trump dictated the whole letter, he didn't write that letter, and that he just made it up as he went along.
Anybody that goes, great health, excellent.
Extraordinary.
Yeah, you have stamina. That calm, it's like,
high energy.
Even in his lie, he has to fucking boost himself up. That's pretty funny.
Those are like non-medical terms.
That's powerful.
Yeah. So this is the doctor.
Yo, look at that dude! He looks like old ass John Lennon.
Wow. He looks like a beetle.
He looks like he has those bald cats. You know what I'm
talking about? Oh, like the skin, the hairless cats?
Yeah, yeah.
The Sphinx cats?
Or like a warlock or some shit.
A warlock.
He definitely has people locked in his basement, for sure.
Oh, damn.
I feel like he lives in those fucking modern art homes where it's just all white and then it's like one coffee table that's black and shit.
With no chairs.
No, the coffee table's a naked girl.
Dude. Yeah, he has no doors. He has just door beads.
And everything's made out of that concrete.
Like he walks in every room.
Fucking hate door beads.
Yeah, door beads.
What's the point of that shit?
I have no idea.
It's so stupid. Like it's just like you ever like go through and then miss one and so then you just like get
stuck. Yeah, it's a pain in the ass every time. I'm like, oh shit. Yeah. Every time.
You gotta go in like this. Yeah. And then spread you gotta, it.
My mom's friend's house had it. Auntie Lisa, they had it like in every hallway. And I don't know why.
Because of feng shui, I'm pretty sure.
Is it?
I'm pretty sure.
Feng shui makes reasonable people do pretty unreasonable. Yeah.
What else is unreasonable?
Well, my wife just does all kinds of weird shit with feng shui. She's everything's goddamn feng shui.
It's a good excuse. Like, there's no reason behind it. She's just like, I feel like it's the feng shui. She's
it
like,
feels
I just
really good though. This chair.
No, and because really I don't know does. Anything about feng shui, she could say anything. Like, I'm like, I would love to have a, you know, a TV in the room. I'd be kick ass, right? But she's like, we can't have a TV in the bedroom because it's against feng shui. And I'm just like.
Does she ever elaborate on that or like?
No,
Google, bro. Google. You have a computer.
Every site contradicts the other site.
It does. Yeah. It's like reading a horoscope set.
I like
right?
how you've tried though. Kudos.
Of course, dude. Of course. So then it's like you know it's Saturday night and we've been drinking and I'm like, hey baby, how about we you know go fuck in the bedroom? And she's like, it's against feng shui. We can't.
It's stupid.
We can't do it.
So yeah. Hold
but
on.
Shit like that, I'm
the
like,
moon is not full.
She's the expert, so
she's
all I can do is
she's just saying that
go,
the sex is boring, so she doesn't want to take it to the bedroom. Ooh. She wants it on the fucking kitchen table.
She's saying it's boring? She's telling you that? She's telling you that?
You know girls talk.
She says wish? It's a little Wait, bit boring, all right?
She's saying it's boring?
Yeah, she's saying it's really boring. You're saying, right.
What do I gotta do?
She's saying she doesn't want to fuck in the bedroom anymore, all right?
She doesn't want to do all the butt things? She's over the butt things?
She's over the missionary.
No, but yeah, it was just kind of funny how this whole thing came out because it's like, it was so obvious that Trump wrote that. I mean, now that we know, now it's kind of obvious when you see the actual wording and yeah. shit.
He even wrote it in his handwriting. He just took the doctor's note and wrote it himself.
The mistake that the media in general makes about stuff like this is they breathlessly report it. Like, it's like, oh my God, the world is ending. Here's this news we have. And we all think it's fucking hilarious.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Cause, you know what I'm saying? Cause
we think it's hilarious, but like people older than us are like, oh my God, that's the truth.
Right.
There's no lie in the news.
Yeah, that's true. That well, there's a lot
I know,
of
my there's so many fucking idiots it. That think the news is real. Yeah.
I know.
Sorry, Mom.
Because I just see it as like a child forging like their mom's, you know, like letter or whatever. And it's just so funny to me that Donald Trump is acting like a kid still.
No,
I see it as a character playing the character. Like, it's like, yeah, that's what we expect. That's why all the Stormy Daniels shit, I'm always like, it like, nothing makes my eyes glaze over more than hearing Stormy Daniels shit. Cause I'm like, yeah. So you're telling me this guy who we all thought was a rich fucking playboy was a rich fucking playboy?
Right? It's like,
this is crazy
it's
shit.
Like, is this supposed to be scandalous? Like, I expect a fucking billionaire to try to bone every single hot actress, porn star, whatever. It doesn't surprise me.
Yeah. I know, all this like Trump news and shit like this too, I'm just like, this is clearly a distraction for something else because they keep reporting all this shit about him, like the fact that he was colluding with Russia, but nothing ever happens. Like, it's just like...
It's I think it's like a smear campaign.
Colluding with Russia, yeah. He was already... It's this... the story is so
the
funny.
The fact that, like, Russia intervened with
There's
the
no,
election...
It's not against the law, first of all. Let's say that he colluded with Russia full bore. Let's say that he was with... Russia was helping him and he knew and he was down. That's not illegal. That's not against the law. Yeah. That's what's so funny about all this shit. Like, they're investigating obstruction of justice, right? That's the whole thing now, right? Is that they're investigating obstruction of justice. But obstruction of justice for what? For firing James Comey. It's the president's constitutional authority to fire the FBI director. The FBI director works under the president. Mm-hmm. He could fire him because he's like, I don't like Jim Comey's hair. He could hire and fire a new FBI director every single day, and that's totally legit because he has the constitutional authority to. So this idea that you're obstructing justice by exercising your constitutional authority is absurd, like on its face. So all this shit about Russia makes me laugh.
I mean, that's what every president does anyway when they get into office, is they bring their own cronies, their own team, and then they wipe it out every time.
Every time.
I mean, Obama did the same thing.
Hillary would have fired James Comey too. Because he fucked up her whole thing. I think Comey was terrible to right. Hillary. Like with all the, you know, he comes out and he's like.
The emails.
With the emails and he's like, well, first of all, he already wrote an exoneration letter for her before they even investigated that situation. But the second thing is, he also came out and said, hey, we're looking at this Hillary situation. Then he said, Hillary's cleared. Then he comes out like a week before the election and says, hey, we're reopening the investigation. Like the guy's terrible. Yeah. She would have fired him too. Who wouldn't have fired James Comey? I want to know.
I think every president is under a microscope and they're always going to face criticism. But when a Republican president is on, it's because the media is owned by mainly, except for Fox News, like was it News Corp, Robert Murdoch, all those guys are hardcore leftists.
Rupert, yeah.
So of course.
Well, no, Rupert Murdoch is the right wing guy.
Oh wait, he's the Fox.
News Corp is Fox, right?
Wait, so what's the other one? There's like five of them, but they're all left.
Yeah, big time.
So that's why it's gonna be super biased like that. And for me, it's like if you know, like I have JK News, I have my agenda. I'ma push what the fuck I want.
You have an agenda? What's your agenda?
Dude, what's your agenda?
Jomalia.
Are we part of this?
That's it. That's all you get.
Jomalia.
That's all you get, Jomalia. I can't tell you the detail.
No, my whole thing is if you don't
but how's your health and cardiovascular?
It's amazing. We train and
it's extraordinary.
It's extraordinary. Yeah. I'm going to be like the first dictator with the perfect health.
Oh. With the perfect health?
Yeah, it's the
will
most
perfect. Will
you please
be the first well-dressed dictator?
All right, I'll try.
He's got capes.
Well,
he's got capes.
But you have to realize that the bar is so low. Like, these guys always wear completely buttoned-up shirts and things.
No, they're like...
That's all psychological.
And weird cloakies things.
He already has that.
They're always late to the, like, you know, the fashion game?
Yeah.
Why do they gotta dress like they're stuck in 1930 cold Russia?
Because they can get away with it.
They should dress for the future.
If you're a dictator, you can get away with
it. Like fucking shoulder pads are going.
Yeah.
That would be tight. Like Bill and Ted future shit.
Yeah. And like shoes that are like fucking huge
with the goldfish inside.
No, that's already been done.
They should dress like Kiss.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
That'd be fucking
that's
sick.
That's exactly what I pictured.
Kiss dictators, that'd be awesome.
If you dress like Kiss, I will probably believe whatever you're saying.
With
no
the,
doubt.
The face paint and all of that?
Yeah, because I want to be part of the counterculture so bad that I'm like, well, this has to be counterculture, whatever you
that's
say.
That's too close to ICP, like, Juggalo stuff.
Oh, true.
No, not if you have the full getup with, like,
oh,
the
spiky
things
fucking
and
shoulder
yeah.
shit.
Yeah. And come out with fire and shit.
Yeah. All right. I think I could do that.
I think you'd be Gene Simmons.
All right. Let's be real, though. You're just going to wear barbell shirts and.
Probably, yeah. But I might do the cape thing. I might.
Barbell capes?